And you're here on behalf of a company known as Ferro, sir?
Ferro Engineering, yes, sir.
Can you tell the jury a little bit about the Ferro company, sir?
Well, we were a supplier of refractory product, hot tops and refractory products to the steel industry. We had our main plant was in Cleveland, Ohio. We had a secondary plant in Cleveland, Ohio also. We had one in Chicago and one in Canada.
What relationship, if any, does Ferro have with the Ogilvy Norton Company?
Ferro Engineering was a division of Ogilvy Norton, and then and now it's a division of Ogilvy Norton Marine Services.
What type of business did Ogilvy Norton engage in, sir?
Well, Ferro was one, in the steel industry. They were in the silica, they were in a sand business. They were in the marine transportation business. Mining taconite mines, taconite, and some docks.
And I think you touched on this. Ogilvy Norton had coal mines, sir?
Early, yes.
They were also involved in silica. You touched on that?
Yes.
They were also involved in selling asbestos hot tops?
Asbestos refractory products, yes.
And are you aware, sir, that all three types of material, coal, silica, and asbestos can cause lung damage?
I do.
And Ferro had salesmen, did they not, sir, that would go out in the field?
They did.
These salesmen went into the field to see how their hot top products were being used?
Well, trying to sell and being used take care of their customers, yes.
Did Ferro have any salesmen that came to Lackawanna in New York where Bethlehem Steel was located?
They did.
What is a hot top?
A hot top is a gray iron casting. That was asbestos. It sits on top of an ingot mold, and when used, when lined with the refractory products, when you steel pour in without a hot top, it forms a pipe, what they call a pipe, a V-shape, where all the impurities, it cools from the outside in, all the impurities gradually go up to the top, and it forms a pipe. With a hot top, the pipe forms in the hot top, and you get anywhere from, depending on the size of the hot top, 3 to, let's say, 15% extra yield from every ingot, which was a huge savings to the steel industry.
And would steel companies like Bethlehem Steel here in Lackawanna, New York, come to Ferro and seek its guidance on hot tops?
Sure. Yes.
When the steel company gave the performance specifications to Ferro, Ferro's engineers and research and development department were the people who were responsible for putting together a formulation that would meet those performance specifications.
Yes.
It was essentially Ferro's decision then to put asbestos in the hot top product.
Yes.
Sir, you mentioned earlier that you worked at the Ferro plant in Ohio.
Yes.
And that's, just so we're clear, that's in Cleveland, sir?
Yes, there was two plants in Cleveland, Plant 1 and a Plant 2.
Can you just very briefly tell the jury the difference between Plant 1 and Plant 2?
What products were made.
What
basically.
Products, just so we're on the same page, were manufactured in Plant 1 versus
Plant 2? Well, we had non-asbestos-type products at Plant 1. We had asbestos-type products. So we had the ferroboard liner, the ferroboard ring, the ferroseal gasket, ferroboard, and at Plant 2 was the ready mix, was the veneer compound, and covers, hot top covers.
Was raw asbestos being used to make those ferroboards, sir?
Yes, sir.
And the bags of raw asbestos came in via train, sir?
The ones from South Africa came in by train, yes.
You would see workers tear open these bags and dump them into a hot tub of water?
They were torn open and they were dumped into a underground vat of water, yes.
And these workers, at the behest of their employer, Ferro Corporation, would take precautions and wear respirators?
Yes.
And you yourself, when you went near this mixing process, you yourself would actually wear a cloth mask, would you not, sir?
That's correct.
And truth be told, you did this in part because at least by that time, you had some understanding that breathing in asbestos could pose a health hazard.
Yes.